What's up, everybody? Welcome in to Turnupmydb, episode one. This is kind of a rebrand of the essentials. Gonna be a little bit different style. Still gonna be bringing you guys some essential stuff, but you know, we're just gonna get into some shit I like. You know what I'm saying? So a lot more sports, always staying in tune with the music because, you know, that's where we come from. And some more current events and, you know, I guess whatever I feel like that day. So let's get into it. First and foremost, I want to congratulate my LA Lakers on winning their 17th championship. Congrats to LeBron on winning his fourth. Shout out to the Heat. They played tremendous. Jimmy Butler balled his ass off. Those young dudes balled their asses off. They're definitely going to be a problem for at least the near future. And that organization, man, the Heat organization is just top notch, man. Coaching, somebody got to put respect on Eric Spoelstra's name. He's one of the best coaches, man. He's one of the best coaches. He doesn't get brought up a lot. You know, you think about the guys like Greg Popovich and recently fired, then hired Doc Rivers, and Eric Spoelstra's never really in that conversation. I really don't know why. Always has his teams ready to play. They never really had a super down year after LeBron left, and so I mean, shout out to the Heat, man. Shout out to Eric Spoelstra. But back to my Lakers. I thought it was tough. I thought they had to deal with a lot with the bubble situation. NBA did a great job of handling the bubble situation and keeping things safe for everybody. You know, these guys not being with their families for months. You know, not having fans. You know, it's a huge change. I mean, when you're used to doing something for so long, it's hard to get adjusted to completely different, like the total opposite. Everything's the total opposite. So I thought it was very challenging for not only the Lakers, but the rest of the NBA teams that played. And so shout out to them, man. Some of the greatest basketball, too. Like as far as offensively, some of the greatest basketball I saw was in the bubble, man. People was just balling, man. Dame Lillard, Jamal Murray, Donovan Mitchell, like they were just hooping their ass off. And we'll see what happens going forward. But, you know, as far as next season, do they do another bubble situation? I know they want to try to stay away from it. Do they maybe have, you know, multiple bubbles, right? Maybe four bubbles, Northwest, you know what I mean? Southwest, however, I don't know how they do it. Definitely something to look out for. Because I think they kind of led the way in the way they handled things. I want to talk about my guy LeBron. Speaking of LA, speaking of the championship, like I said, shout out to LeBron winning his fourth championship. Like he said, put some damn respect on his name. People that know me know that I have not always been a LeBron fan. I want to say it was about year two when he went back to Cleveland. And I was like, yo, this dude, you got to give him respect. Like, you got to give him his flowers, man. Like, because he's doing something. Like, okay, take the top five. Take all that out of it. Like, wherever you rank LeBron in your top five, top 10, your all-time list, that's on you. You know, we're not going to argue that. And I'm not going to give you my list. I want to speak to LeBron. And a certain point is the guy went to 10 finals. He went to, what was it, 8, 9 in a row? If it wasn't for him getting injured last year, he could have possibly been in there last year. Like, we don't know. He got injured. The season got away from the Lakers, and it was what it was, right? Yeah, so, I mean, we just don't know. Like, we just don't know what could have, would have, should have happened. But the guy is great. The guy is great. And you know, like, when he said put some respect on his name, it's funny because they win the championship. They won. And immediately there's tweets, there's Instagram posts, there's pictures, Michael Jordan, and you know, they're, oh well, but he's not better than Michael Jordan. He's not better than Michael Jordan. He didn't go 6 for 6.
But he didn't face the Clippers. He didn't face the Clippers. This is a weak championship. He faced the Heat. Oh, he faced the Heat. They don't have no superstar. Oh, Jimmy Butler, he's inconsistent. They were a 5 seed. But he went to 10. He only won 4. Would you say he's not the greatest?
It's like, bruh, he just won another championship. Do you know how hard it is to win a championship in any professional league? Like, if you pay attention to sports and you have all this knowledge about sports, you know how hard it is. Like, it's hard to win one, even harder to go back to back. And a lot of times you have the same team, and it's hard to go back to back. Stop hating on this dude, man. Stop hating on this dude. You know, it's like, oh, the Clippers. They didn't face the Clippers. The Clippers got beat. They got beat. They had a 3-1 lead, and they got their asses kicked. Period. They faced the 5 seed. The Heat were the 5 seed. And they beat everybody in the Eastern Conference to get to the finals. At the end of the day, it's about what's in front of you, who's in front of you, and do you beat them or not? Dubs and L's. So stop hating on Bron. Are the Lakers, man, and I love the Lakers, are the Lakers winning the championship without Bron on the team? No. No. AD's great. But come on now. And it goes to my point of, when do we start, or when did we stop appreciating greatness? Like, back in the days, we've always had dynasties throughout history of sports. We've always had dynasties. When did we stop appreciating greatness? Like, even back then, even if you hated the fact that certain teams made it every year, every other year, you always appreciated it. Like, yeah, but there's some bad dudes, man. Like, there's some bad dudes. Like, they are great. I can't argue that. Like, they are great. Michael Jordan in his heyday. And I got the Michael Jordan poster on the wall right here. I got 3 Michael Jordan pictures in my office right here at the studios. I'm a Michael Jordan fan. But he never got the amount of hate. He was appreciated across the world. Like, people who were fans of teams that hated Chicago showed up to, it's like, we got to see Mike. We got to see Mike in person. He's that guy. He's that guy. When did it become okay to not appreciate greatness? I mean, think about what happened with Kobe, man. When Kobe was playing, everybody hated him. He was great. He was an assassin. Everybody hated him. He gets out. People still kind of hated him. Like, oh man, he gets out. He's still doing great. He was dominant in a sport. Now he's being dominant in everything else that he's doing. And they were still hating him. And then he passes away. And everybody wants to show love. And I think we're getting very close to having a situation like that with Bron. You can love him. You can hate him. You could be a fan of his, not a fan of his. But you got to appreciate what this guy does. Like, do you know how hard it is just to get to? Is every team getting to the motherfucking finals? Is everybody getting to the finals? Is every team getting to the Super Bowl? Is every team getting to the World Series? You have teams that go years and years and years. Players that go years and years and years don't even make the final. Great players. Great players don't even sniff the finals. Appreciate this man while he's here. What you going to do if he wins another 2? He wins another 2. He goes 6-12, 6-13, but he's been to 13, and he won 6. What you going to do? You going to hate then? He wasn't perfect. He wasn't perfect. He wasn't Michael Jordan. He wasn't 6-6. Hey, I'm going to be honest with you. Michael Jordan is at the top of my list. Michael Jordan is my personal greatest of all time. But Jordan was getting his ass kicked for a little bit there until he finally got over the hump. And he got over the hump when Scottie Pippen got there. Same thing happens with Brady. Same thing started happening with Steph. We love Steph Curry, right? Oh, Steph, man, he's doing incredible things. They start winning, get a couple championships. Yo, fuck Steph Curry. What? Why? Why? he's hooping. Now then he gets injured. Oh man. Yeah, see. It's a fucking injury. What are you talking about? We gotta appreciate our grace, man. We gotta appreciate greatness. We all strive to be great. Why are we hating on people for being great? It's your job to do your job and be great. I don't know. Y'all need to stop hating out there. NFL, how we feel about the NFL right now? How we feel? We, few weeks in, NFC East sucks all across the board. Dak Prescott, man. Oh my God. Did y'all see the injury? Oh my God. Again, whether you love or hate a player or a team or an organization, you never want to see that happen to any player. It's just a freak accident. It reminded me a lot of years ago, Louisville basketball team, men's basketball team was in, and I think it was in the tournament in March Madness. And a kid goes up, I can't remember his name, a kid goes up for a routine three, lands, leg just breaks. Like, doesn't land weird, just jumps up, lands, leg, breaks in half. Just a freak accident, man. I hope he gets back right. I know he was looking for his money. I hope he gets back right. I hope he gets back to his form. I would take my, if I'm Dak Prescott, man, take your time, man. Take your time, get 100% healthy, and make sure that if it's not with the Cowboys, whoever is with, you're going to get your money. You know what I'm saying? Don't be trying to rush, get back out there, and then, you know, either re-injure it or be playing a little nervous, which happens. It happens to anybody who comes back from injury. And then injure something else because, you know, you're not playing at full speed. So my prayers, my thoughts with Dak Prescott, man, him getting carted off the field, seeing him cry, man, it just tears you apart, man. These guys love what they do. It doesn't matter, like I said, if you love or hate the team, love or hate the person that you don't know. It sucks to see people go out that way. Coronavirus is spreading rapidly throughout the NFL. They have the most weird testing protocols I've seen. They're winging it like the NFL always does, and it makes you upset because they're not, you know, they talk so much shit about protecting the product, but, you know, which is football. I'm not talking about the players. And they talk shit about protecting the players as well, right? They just fucking wing it, man. They just wing it. Like, they don't care. They really don't give a fuck. I mean, even freaking college football has done better than these dudes, man. But with that being said, Nick Saban just came down with Nick Saban, coach of Alabama. Football team just came down with coronavirus, tested positive, showing asymptomatic right now. But what are you guys' thoughts on, you know, how the NFL is handling it? Now, I will say this. MLB kind of had a little scared there in the beginning. They were kind of winging it, and they figured it out. And obviously we're here watching the World Series. So we'll see what the NFL does, but they got to figure it out, man. It's like every week, reschedule, which we know it may happen, but you got to tighten it the fuck up. Speaking of the World Series, my Dodgers are killing me. But it's been some really, really dope baseball, really good baseball going on. I don't like the back-to-back-to-back-to-back games. I feel like you need to give players a little bit of rest. It may shift the momentum for certain teams, just like in the NBA, the bubble shifted momentum for certain teams. It'd be really interesting to see how this all plays out, you know. The MLB kind of figured it out towards the end. I just don't agree with the back-to-back-to-back games. Like, give these guys a chance to rest. Go every other day like the NBA did, you know, but we'll see. You know, it does happen in, you know, youth baseball and college baseball, and maybe, you know, these guys are a little bit older, man. You gotta rest their bodies, man. They need ice. What else is going on, man? What do you guys think about everything I just talked about? MLB, NFL, NBA, what are your thoughts? If you hate on the Lakers, then go ahead, hate, whatever. What else is going on? What else is going on out there? What are you guys watching? The Boys? Did you guys finish The Boys? I have not finished it. I still have two more episodes to go. So by the next episode of Turnupmydb, I will have an opinion about it. We'll see. But dope show so far. I just hate that it's so short. So I want to do a little segment every show on Turnupmydb. Obviously, we do the Gray Space reviews. This is, and obviously we have What You Heard with Zeke. This is my personal in the rotation, and this will be called, the part of the show will be Turnupmydb. So I'm going to give you a few albums that are in my rotation. First and foremost, The New Reason. The artist's name is Reason. The album is New Beginnings.
Yeah. I might slip, I don't fall. If I slip, I might crawl. I just drip, I got sauce. I just drip, I got sauce. If she dip, that bitch lost. I don't trip, I'm a boss. I might slip, I don't fall. I just drip,
wait, ride around town on Sunset. Cali weed loud like funk flex. Road trip, slow drip, don't rush shit. No bitch ass nigga, no fuck shit. No fuck shit, get chin check. Treat a queen like a queen, don't give a bitch shit. New whip shit.
I'm pretty sure we're gonna be doing a review on this, so be looking out for that. Incredible album, dope listen, debut album from Reason on TDE. Go check it out. Definitely some dope music on there. I don't want to give you too much of a breakdown, obviously, because I want to save that for the Gray Space reviews. YG, My Life 400.
I'm out on bail, these motherfuckers tryna get me. But I won't tell, so with some time they tryna hit me. I'm innocent as fuck, but they tryna pull that I'm guilty. These lower fees is crazy, thank God I'm playing with millions. In love with the streets, you by yourself a nigga tricky. Beefing with my homies, all I think about is Nipsey. Usually sip tequila, but today I'm off the Henny. Thinking about Nipsey, nigga, had to get tipsy. Gave my heart to the gang, do it a gang. It's a no-go, it's some niggas from the gang. Nigga, do you for some promo. This shit in my veins, I done tattooed the logo. In court, they gon' judge me, he a member, it's for social.
YG. It's a classic YG album. If you love YG, if you love that West Coast sound, which is all I'm about, YG, My Life 400. How many more? I got a couple more. Sticking to the West Coast, Mozzy, Occupational Hazard. We did do a review on this one. Go check out the review for a little bit more detail and to see how I actually feel where I have the album as far as my rank for the album. But man, Mozzy is an animal when it comes to this music. That Bay, his particular Bay Area sound is a Sactown kind of sound, and it's fire. I love what he's doing. Love what he's doing.
Baby mama mother asked her daughter, was she seeing me? Damn, I miss my granny, she the only one believed in me. Never picture you leaving me, whatever you are. I hope it's frequent that you think of me forever. You are the only one that's hard to live without eternally scarred. Got the news and lost control, yeah, I told on my car. I always listen when you told me I should follow my heart. This will let me broken pieces.
Think I'm gonna give y'all one more. You know what's been in my rotation heavy? Skip Marley, Higher Place. I've been wanting to talk about this album.
Yes. This is the biggest. Yes. It's such a beautiful day.
positive that you are. Satisfaction is my reaction every time I'm near your heart. Can you feel it? No, you see it. So many people in pain. Thank God for the love we share, Lord. Even though it's rough out there, no one knows. Seems no.
Skip Marley, Higher Place, is a fire album. Now, it is an LP because it's seven songs, and I think seven songs is like literally the limit for LP. I have it as an EP just because I feel like it's a little short. We are not going to review this because I feel like it's so short, but I will say that if I had to rank it for just the music that's there, I would give it 10 clouds for sure. This album, if you want to relax, if you want to jump in the whip, if you want good, solid vibes, oh my gosh, this album from song one to song seven, it just goes. Great features on here. Ari Lennox, Rick Ross. I think he's got Damian Marley on there. Her, like, this album is, please, if you do nothing else, because this will not be on the reviews, for me, for Turn Up My DB, go grab this album, Skip Marley, Higher Place. Trust me, you'll be doing yourself a favor. Thank you guys for tuning in to the reinstallment of The Essentials. The rebrand, actually, Turn Up My DB. Until next time, like my man Zeke would say, stay safe, stay positive, and always stay up. And I'll see y'all. One.